beauty has been banned. There will be no more getting your hair did, at least in Afghanistan, according to the new and improved super chill Taliban that we were all promised after we left there. Oh boy. Women's beauty salons were banned in Afghanistan because they offered services forbidden by Islam and caused economic hardships for grooms' families during wedding festivities, the Taliban said on Thursday. The explanation came days after the group confirmed they were giving all salons a very generous 1 month to wind down their businesses in the country and close up shop, drawing concern from international officials worried about the impact on female entrepreneurs. The ruling is the latest curb on the rights and freedoms of Afghan women and girls, following edicts barring them from, oh, just a couple things like education, public spaces, and most forms of employment. In a video clip released Thursday, Sadiq Akif Majer, the spokesman for the Taliban-run Virtue and Vice Ministry, listed a series of services salons offered that he said went against Islam. Those included eyebrow shaping, how dare you in front of the Lord, the use of other people's hair to augment a woman's natural hair, what is this, Halloween? And the application of makeup, which, heaven forbid, would interfere with the ablutions required before offering prayers. If you're gonna pray to God, make sure it's without something to even out your skin tone. Please, for the love of humanity. In addition, the salons cause economic stress on grooms' families who are required by custom to pay for the pre-wedding salon visit by the bride and her close family relatives. I do feel them on that one. The ban comes days after Taliban Supreme Leader Hibatullah Akhundzada, did I pronounce his last name correctly? Akhundzada claimed his government had taken steps for the betterment of women's lives in Afghanistan. Akhundzada, the perfect name, continuing the time-honored tradition of politicians saying the exact opposite of what they're doing. Amina Sharifi, who owns a Kabul salon, said she was the only breadwinner in her family since her husband, a former policeman, had been unemployed since the Taliban took power in August 2021. The beauty salon was our only income, and now I don't know what to do. How should we pay for our expenses, the mother of four said. The families of three other women working for her will also lose their incomes. So things are shaping up, as everybody probably predicted, in Afghanistan.
Yeah. So look, all fundamentalists hate freedom. Because by definition, they're fundamentalists, so they say, I'm right about everything, whether it's religious or political, more religious, unfortunately, these days on planet Earth. And they say, and I was told by God or some other mythical creature, and it's 100% correct because it's handed down by God, so you can't disagree with it. Well, that's a disastrous way to run a society. And so, and it doesn't matter which religion it is, all fundamentalists are wrong. Okay, all right. Now, secondly, they say, well, you can't criticize my culture. No, wrong again, Bob. I can and I will. And so I was born Muslim, I grew up Muslim. Not all Muslims are fundamentalists. In fact, the overwhelming majority of Muslims are not fundamentalists. They have uncles and aunts and grandmothers and kids just like yours, okay? But these fundamentalists, just as fundamentalist Christians in America make all Christians look bad. Oh, Jesus told me to buy a jet and make you pay for it. Really, did Jesus? And these Taliban losers. Oh, we are sure that men are superior to women. That's why don't let them get educated, because they're definitely gonna kick our ass. Don't give them equal rights. Oh my God, don't do it, don't do it, don't do it. Oh, please, please don't let them look, go to a beauty salon. I mean, look at us, we're disasters. We don't want them looking good. Yeah, that's what I thought. Losers, your culture sucks. Give women equal rights, let them get educated, let them have freedom. And that stands for, that goes to all the fundamentalist religions that keep telling you to discriminate against different groups because God told them. Yeah, why doesn't God ever tell anybody to do something nice? And the reality is he does. Unfortunately, the hateful part of a lot of these religions have won over these fundamentalist areas, and they're leading to a toxic culture we all have to fight together.
Yeah, 100%. The foundation of fundamentalism is fear and insecurity at the end of the day. But it really just blows my mind how much the United States has destroyed much of the Middle East and Afghanistan, and really imperial powers throughout the last couple of hundred years involvement in the Afghanistan area. It really has led to what it is today.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.